I'd heard of Jessie Slocum off and on for quite a while. I'd heard the talk of Jessie and her man. My friends would often joke and say, be careful of your gym. Don't ever let her get her hooks on him. And Jessie didn't draw no lines when she saw a man she liked. She wouldn't rest till she had him in her arms. I'd heard the mayor and police chief, to mention just a few, had sampled some of Jessie Slocum's charms. Now they found Jessie Slocum in her bedroom Wednesday night. They found her with a bullet in her head. Now Jessie Slocum sure know how to treat a man all right, but she won't no more 'cause Jessie Slocum's dead. Now just about 2 months ago, my Jim did something strange. He took a bowling every Wednesday night, and every week he'd be a little later coming home. Some told me things just weren't going right. And then last week I followed Jim to where he's supposed to bowl. He went up to the bar and had himself a drink. Then sure enough, about 15 minutes later, out he went. I stood there crying, too confused to think. Now I watched him as he walked about a half a block up the street. I felt the blood start draining from my face. Well, he paused for just a second, then he opened up the door, and he climbed the steps to Jessie Slocum's place. Well, they found Jessie Slocum in her bedroom Wednesday night. They found her with a bullet in her head. Now Jessie Slocum sure know how to treat a man all right, but she won't no more 'cause Jessie Slocum. Never really tried. Too many questions could have turned too many faces red, so they called it just an unsolved homicide. Now I took back my Jimmy 'cause I'm still his lawful wife. I promised that the day that we were wed, and I'll do my best to love him, though I know we'll go through life with the ghost of Jessie Slocum in our bed.